Welcome, everybody. This is the No Name Show with Chris and, well, I don't know.
Who? What is our name?
Hello.
What's it?
Hi.
Hello.
Oh, hi, hello. I'm Chris. Whoa. We just met. Okay. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I guess I'm hanging out here. We both have some hats on.
Cool.
So
we had a little Built for the Wild here.
Yeah. Went to the Kumquat Festival
in
Dade City, and I got a new little
Kumquat
hat here.
Did you say?
Kumquat, did you say?
She coined that phrase.
Yeah, that's me. That's all me. Yeah. So I got a new hat, 25 smackaroos at the Kumquat Festival, and yeah, I'm digging it. So anyway, hubby and I here. 25 years, husband and wife, and
that's crazy. I know, I'm only 28.
I like to get them young. Oh, yeah, that's bad. So we're talking tonight about the music, the reviews, the whole, like, what are they, the
the reviews, what do you mean?
Not the reviews, the whole video, reaction videos.
Oh,
reaction,
yes.
Yeah, the reaction videos.
Yeah.
So, we're Gen X. That's what we are. Yeah.
Born in the 70s.
Yeah.
And, yeah, so we love them. We love those videos.
Yeah,
we do. I especially love the professional singers that hear a genre of music or band they've never heard before. I love the reactions, you know. And so we thought we'd do a reaction of a reaction.
Well, there's reactions of reactions, but there's also, like, we haven't heard jack crap. Like, okay, we played a trivia night at the local place. We live in Lakeland, Cobb and Penn. Okay, Monday nights, trivia nights. And the category was music. Like, I always know I'm gonna, like,
and we usually do
this.
Really good in these trivia things.
Yeah, but we don't know jack crap. Like, mm-hmm. 4 of the 5 questions, we were just totally no
who?
Clue. Who? Like, I put Shania Twain because I'm like,
we're
who
like
do I not
A-
listen to?
A-R-C- what?
A-Y-R-Y-C? I don't even know. Some band, some boy, young people band.
Yeah. So
we don't know
sad.
Anything.
It's sad.
Yeah. Yeah. We know sad. Nothing about today's music. And I am 50. And so anyway, we're thinking, like, okay, let's listen to some new music, but let's show the young people our music. So we want to, like, do our music and their music and try to react to it, because you never know. It might be good. It might be ridiculous. I don't know. We are very specific in our taste. So
hey, can't be wrong to try.
No.
You know?
So I guess first, let's listen to something we like, because we're selfish, and something we like. Oh, okay, I like a lot, but he likes too. And it's a band that I think is incredibly underrated, and that is the Butthole Surfers. And yes, okay, like I said, I'm Gen X, so
for sure.
This is Butthole Surfers, Strawberry.
Oh, it's this way. Yeah.
Yeah.
Never mind.
But before we get into our lovely song, Strawberry, I just want to say I tried a new brew tonight. This is something I picked up at the local place here. I love beer, so let's see. Bam. It's backwards. Super Freak. This is like total Rick James. We should also listen to Super Freak just because, but
everyone should listen to Super
Freak. Everyone should listen to Super Freak. Yes, I bought it for the name. No, I'm not ashamed. I like Super Freak.
She's a sucker for a good package.
I am, and it is coconut, caramel, and chocolate. I'm going to let him try it because I don't think he's going to like it. I like this stuff. So
I'll probably like it, but
well,
first of all, she's pouring it wrong. She just went just like right into the middle of the bottom of the glass. It's like, okay.
I never made sidewall, it to bartender when
and then
I
bring it up did. And then let it just, you gotta let it blossom.
Yeah, I didn't do that, so.
She just smashed it.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, I smashed it beer.
It's like I just totally ruined it. I already had one. I
smells know. Like
chocolate.
Smells like Savannah, Georgia. Okay. I'm sorry.
That's
love
not
Savannah.
Untrue.
I'm sorry.
That's not untrue.
I didn't mean it in a bad way. I meant it smells good.
Sorry, Savannah. You're not gonna be able to drink it now. It's like, okay.
It smells okay. Like chocolate or peanut butter.
Right.
Okay. Someone put freaking Yoo-Hoo in this.
No,
it's like
not
coffee. It's like coffee
okay.
And Yoo-Hoo.
I feel like you're hating on my stuff now. Like this is, it's good. It's super freak.
It actually does taste pretty good. It's pretty good.
It's
what's,
brown
what's ale. The ABC? ABV.
You know, I feel like you're judgmental.
No, I'm
let's just
asking.
Say it's over four.
What is it?
Less than 10. I mean, you should be proud of me. It's less than
that'll
10.
Affect my opinion it's, of its taste.
I mean, I'll show you.
Oh, it's a 7.5 and it drinks like a 4. It drinks like a 4.5.
I mean, yeah.
It's a good smooth 7.5.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not necessarily my flavor.
It's mine. I like it. So
I like it's really good. Oh, you know what? I've had Duclaw before. Duclaw Brewing, good job.
They do Sweet Baby Jesus too.
Yeah. Thank you. And we're not getting any compensation for that. This
anyway,
is genuine
yeah, we
compliment
just like,
to Duclaw Brewery.
I like
thank
beer.
You. We love your beers.
All right. So this is Butthole Surfer Strawberry. This is our pick. And then we're going to play a top 20 song.
Here we go.
All right.
She's got the okay. Oh, full screen, maybe.
I am full screen. You can full screen. I can click on this. By the way, this is how I dance in my head
got to be this bump, I just don't know.
This is how the part I'm singing. Yeah, this is what I'm listening to. Yeah, you hear it? You hear it? Yeah.
It says I'm going through this yellow.
I'm running this yellow. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's not. Yeah. Go ahead and cross with the little pool. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You don't hear what I'm hearing? No. Yeah, you're listening to the wrong thing. Yeah. That's me.
Sunday, Monday, got to settle down. Got to get my feet back on the ground. Wednesday, Thursday, got nothing to show. Why don't you tell me something I don't know?
I love the Butthole Surfers. Our daughter loves the Butthole Surfers. We love the Butthole Surfers.
Can't believe the mainstream has missed this. Ah.
It's a shame. It truly is. Now, okay, I listened to him back in the day, like for serious, I did back in the day, but I'm listening to him more now because I have different appreciation for him now. I totally do.
Yeah. Back in the day, you almost felt guilty. Okay. We actually heard a lot of this for the first time on cassette tapes.
Right.
And you're talking like 3-inch speakers with a battery powered thing. Sometimes it'd be playing at a different speed than it was supposed to be.
You know, the best thing about cassettes, the best thing was when they get all effed up. Okay, I don't want to cuss and stuff. I'll try to keep it nice, but they get all effed up in your cassette player and you have to take your number two pencil, the best thing ever invented, number two and pencil, and you tighten it. Remember getting it so tight? Sometimes you break that shit.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry.
Or you'd play the tape so much it would break.
Yeah. That was
What I'm saying is when, you know, with the quality of the play, you didn't know if some of the sounds you were hearing were intentional.
Yeah.
So you didn't really realize the full quality of the musicianship.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Especially coming from punk, where some of it was kind of, you know, unrefined. You didn't realize how good the Butthole Surfers were until you got a good recording, which wasn't until way later.
Yeah. Yeah, we got a teen girl out there playing Fortnite, so it's interesting. Every now and then we get screams.
She listens to cooler shit than I ever did.
Oh gosh, she's way ahead of me.
Yeah, she's got some good tape.
So needless to say, like, we love that crowd.
Okay, so what's the modern thing? What? Okay.
Okay, so
do you have something in mind that's going to be a modern comparable?
Okay, I'm jumping on the bandwagon, and I'm going to start by saying, okay, I'm just going to say it. I'm judgmental. Okay, yeah.
No.
Okay. I love original recordings. Like, if somebody puts something out, that's how they intended it, that's how they made it. And it's not very often I like a I know, but it's not Johnny Cash doing Hurt. I love that. Mm-hmm. That's like one of the best remakes I think ever. It's not very often I like when somebody does somebody else's song. It's very rare. So I'm picking on somebody today, and Can you guess who it is? I'm sorry. This she's all in the news and shit. I'm sorry. T S. I know, and I didn't, of course she's in the top 10, whatever, 20, I don't.
Well, hold on. Wait.
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna say something here,
Okay,
and
say
she's not gonna
something.
like me. A
Me?
lot of yeah.
Me?
A lot of times we disagree. Okay, 80% of the shit that you love, that you think is original, is a fucking remake.
Okay, I
Or it is someone
know.
else's rendition of a song.
I understand that, like most of the stuff, okay, White Stripes. Okay. So they took a lot from the blues, and they took a lot, and most of the, like, look at
Well,
Elvis and the
no,
Beatles and
and a
everybody.
lot of
They
that,
took a lot from.
no, Jack White, he is original, but he does little nods to those historical figures. There's a couple of remakes he's done.
I know, but they're like my favorite songs of his, with
Okay.
White Stripes and with that, you know what I mean? Like, so it every now and then I do like. I love it. It's like they made it something. Well, look at Whitney Houston with Dolly Parton. I mean, that was a big deal. I Will Always Love You. I mean, that is, she made that song. So I'm gonna listen. I am not going to say I'm gonna like it.
Okay, well, so some remakes, I agree. You can call them
And
remakes. You can call them a
this.
remake because they're not an artist, and they're not in, they're not like an artist's representation of something that inspired them. It's just a remake.
It's just a remake, and they don't put the love into it that the part in this song. This is so Gen X. This song is so Gen X, and this song I sang and listened to. I want to say I know very well over 1,000 times. I know I've heard it over 1,000 times, and that's quite a bit for songs. If you think about it, like, that's quite a lot. I listened to this. This was when MTV was in its freaking height, and I've seen this video forever. Like, so I hope, just seeing the name, if she actually did this, if she actually did this. I don't
In the future,
Maybe
all of
she
us
did,
have
maybe she
powers.
didn't.
We
I
have
don't
to
know.
figure
This
out
is
why
what it
it's good
is.
to us.
If she did it
Seeing
totally
the
different.
future is just
It
the
just goes to
beginning.
show you how
It
much
sounds
I
like
don't
every
know
therapy
about what's
session I've
on.
avoided.
Madam Web, I'm
Okay,
here to
you
deal with
have
your
kept me
fortune.
waiting so long.
It's literally been like 10 minutes. Okay.
Leave a dream high in the quiet of the night. You know that I caught
Warning.
it. Shiny toy with a price, you know that I bought it.
I feel a
Can't
weight
put
lifted
me
off my chest
slow out the
right
window. I'm always
now.
waiting for you to be waiting below. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. What doesn't kill me makes me want you
It's not my
more.
song.
Is there, where's the bubble gum? What?
Actually the song, like, is this the
You're
song that
cutting
Whitney Houston
candy
did?
here?
I don't know.
I want to jump in a bounce house right now.
Okay. There it is. Oh my gosh, honey, you just don't even know. Like, if she did banana. I thought she did banana ring song. Like,
She's professional.
This song,
She is a
I'm sorry, but it
professional.
sucks. Okay.
You can't go from the Butthole Surfers to Taylor Swift. You can't do it.
It's on me. Okay.
What?
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Let me take a sip of my beer. Number one.
Oh my
God. I'd like to apologize for thinking she remade this cool summer. Because I love that song. It's like a staple of my childhood. Okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you for not. I don't want to say screwing it up, but that's really. That's the first words that popped in my head. I'm sorry. Number two. Okay. I don't like Taylor Swift. I'm sorry. I don't like her. I don't like her music. I haven't heard anything from her. It's nothing against Taylor Swift. It's not my bag. Okay. So, all right. Let me just pick a different song. Okay. I'm just going to pick a different song. I can't. Oh my God. Okay. I didn't even give it a chance. I didn't even make it 1 minute and 40 seconds, honey. I didn't make it.
It was a nice try. It was a nice try.
Let's go with, okay, this is, I haven't heard of any of these songs. This is the top 10 songs.
Oh, really? Top 10 songs according to who?
It was on Google. It's Google. Google top 10 songs. Okay. I'm just a little messed up right now.
Are they new songs?
Yes, these are all new songs. I don't recognize any of these artists, so. Except for Swift. She was the only one in.
Well, we got to do something that's not like rock.
None of this is rock. I don't know what any of this is. Like, this is all new stuff.
So that's both?
I don't know what that is.
What is that? Type it.
Okay.
With Too Savage?
I don't know.
Tiesto?
With.
What is that? Oh, they're going to laugh.
I don't know what the hell this is.
No, we're too slow. They're already gone. They're not even here. Okay. With Too Savage.
I put the caps lock on. I'm sorry. I'm still. Okay.
Oh, there it is. Tiesto and Bia both with 21
it's
Savage.
It's a 3 minute song. I mean,
we're expecting a quarterback.
Okay.
This we're is working on his football IQ. This is more than like the.
No Kroger's.
So,
did you bring it home?
I think that was definitely.
That was pretty good. Now that was on number one on the charts right now. Or
that's
something?
Number one right
according
now.
To Google.
Well, I just looked up the top.
And who was that? Tiesto.
I don't know. Savage Tiesto with I don't know. Savage Tiesto. I don't know any of these people.
It was all digital. There was no like.
Yeah, there's no like
mix and like digital sampling.
But this is the thing about sampling, because one of my favorites is like, think about the Beastie Boys, you think about Run DMC, you think about all them. They all sampled their music. And even like looking at like Led Zeppelin and Elvis, and I mean, everybody, you could call it influence or you can call it sampling. Like they took somebody else's music and they made it their own.
Well, but that's really that's music and musicians want that. Music is alive.
Yeah.
It's a language. Music is a way to express emotion.
It's art.
It is. It's moving, living art.
Yeah.
And if a musician takes a piece and embellishes it or does a rendition that's in their style or something, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
And let the market decide, you know, who gets albums bought and stuff
right.
like that. Yeah. Absolutely.
And that's who's going to do it. I mean, some of my, like, when I say underrated, I'm like, you know what? They're my special band, so stay away. It's kind of like Florida. It's like, it's my state, so if you don't like it here, good. Stay in Toronto or wherever, you know?
You know, it's funny because there's the whole, like, Florida man thing.
Yeah.
And it's just something that's easy to say.
Mm-hmm.
Because, honestly, there's crazy shit that happens everywhere. I've been everywhere, man. And I tell you, we traveled all around the country.
Yeah.
We saw the news. We saw people. We saw up close, personal.
Yeah.
There's crazy everywhere, okay? It's not any one state. It's not any one county. Well, Okay, I take that back.
Don't talk about Mississippi police like that.
No, I'm not going to say
any. Okay,
No, no. There are places that are worse than others.
Yeah.
However, there's crazy everywhere.
Yeah.
And some of it's good.
We'll talk about that another time, I guess.
Yeah.
I guess we should wrap this up.
Yeah, we've gone on way too long.
Yeah.
We'll do another one. Hope you guys enjoyed falling asleep to our video. And much love to everybody.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next time.
All right.